God, I am just going to have this video raw as it is. We have been going through a lot recently. The spiritual battle has been intensified and has been very, very tough. Living where we have been living, all sorts of problems. You can't imagine that led to the robbery of our car, a potential house robbery. And Jesus Christ has been there, the only one there for us, always. Jesus Christ, our Father, the Holy Spirit, leading us, helping us to notice what we are doing wrong, helping us to notice the attacks of the enemy, the mind of the enemy, because all this is about that. Learning how the enemy works, how the enemy manipulates, bully, harasses, and all that, simply to help us develop our ammunition in the spirit and close the cracks in our armor. God, you have helped us. It has been extremely hard. I just decided to do this video because I removed some of the videos of the testimony, simply because I wanted to expand on certain things, and rather than being quite fearful and always trying to come up with a smile in that everything is okay, I have decided to or go quiet when it is so tough. I want to start honoring the journey and how tough it is to leave Babylon, to come out of Babylon, to come out of her, not to partake of her sins, and not to take of the plagues that are coming or that are already unfolding here in cities like London, capital cities. Babylon is the system, is global, is just the conditioning that we have received to live a life with a certain technique that people have mastered, just education, work. We are just born, we study, we work, and we pay to get a house, a car, and the best conditions in life that we can have, to then die and expand empire as much as we can, and then die. And that has left no fulfillment at all. When I left banking in 97 and we started to live by faith, we started to leave behind many things, titles, diplomas, material things, living in rooms, then meeting and living together and trying to be truly focused in our journey towards God, exploring the New Age, exploring all sorts of New Age groups. And in that process, finding God, finding Jesus Christ, the way, the truth, the life, the one that is always there for you when everything fails, when everyone betrays you, when everyone criticizes you, when everyone ridicules you, mock you for your decisions. And He is there. He has been there to date. I want to honor that. I just decided to do this video to tell you where we are at the moment. To tell the world Jesus is the way, the truth, the life. He truly comes to baptize us with fire. The fire of His Holy Spirit that incinerates everything that is not His. So that we can't live and find that kingdom. If we follow the kingdom, everything else comes in addition. Through this journey and through the last months that have been really, really tough, and I will go into that later, another video, I have received dreams and the gift of healing, and it has been amazing. Realizations, dreams, insights, where to go, insights with our parents as well, I had a terrible dream with my parents both going to hell. That is giving me a lot of concerns. I'm very worried about them. They are in Colombia for our relationship, completely broken and dysfunctional to date as well. They cannot understand our journey, our trying to seek God, asking, seeking, knocking. They cannot understand that lifestyle. They were never interested and they are not interested to date. After two abortions that they had, I was born. And divorce, all sorts of issues, Freemasons in the family, and all sorts of generational curses that to date I never imagined were so powerful and were so easy to break as well. Covering ourselves with the blood of Jesus Christ, who comes not only to restore us, but to heal us and to leave us with His Holy Spirit, to baptize us with fire, with the fire that incinerates our sin, incinerates everything that is not His, so that we can be sanctified, that we can resensitize ourselves to the laws of God that have been lost. And so through this journey from complete tolerance and accepting so many things, being so lukewarm, to feeling so much remorse even for things that happened so long ago that you did, because now the closer you get to the truth, the more you see the lies that you lived, the more you see the lies that have been there conditioning you, affecting you. And I just want to close anyway, just simply saying how important it is to develop our relationship. And in these moments, God is closing doors. I don't know if in London, the UK, but He's forcing us to truly live a lifestyle applying the teachings of Jesus Christ. And when the core teachings is leave everything, leave everyone, and follow me. If you don't leave your parents, your children, your spouse, even the world, your job, your positions, your house, your mansion, your car, you don't deserve me. And God is closing all doors. It has been horrendous, the attacks of the enemy. It's beyond flesh and blood. We know that. Read Ephesians 6 if you want to explore the warfare. We are born in a warfare, and we is beyond flesh and blood, and we have been able to pass our tests trying to seal the cracks in our armor with the belt of truth, the breastplate of righteousness, the shoes of readiness for the gospel of peace, the shield of faith, the sword of the word of God, the helmet of salvation, and the mantle of praise, praying ceaselessly as never before. And leaving now, we found a room, apparently a wonderful moment, because when it was imminent, we didn't want to get caught up in contracts and things and staying an ORG or minimum contracts, letting or whatever, and we just found a room. It was the only card on the window staring at us, and we found someone. And right now, it is just within weeks, it is a mess. God is closing certainly the doors, and we don't know what is our next step. I want to ask you for prayers. I want to ask for your prayers urgently, so that God really help us to discern from our fears and the next step that He's calling us to take. If He's here, Colombia, China, wherever it is, it's just the certainty that He talks to us. And right now, Today is como I had a dream as well, healing in my dreams and saying in the name of Jesus Christ, you are healed. And I've had a couple of dreams in the last year about healing others, and it has been very, very good to see as well with Richard some healing have taken place. And this morning I just left the house and I just saw someone that we have seen sometimes in the libraries, and I have never seen him with a stick, and I knew he was in the house, and I thought he was making like the sign of a cross or something. Oh, he believes in Jesus Christ. Somehow I just left the car and Richard was waiting for me, and I went to the bus stop where he was waiting for the bus, and I was so scared. So yeah, it was so a little bit challenging, but I knew what I had seen in the dream and the lines. I was even giving the lines just to give chance to the only one who can help you, can heal you. And I didn't mention that. I just simply said, oh, hello, how are you? And just, yeah, the hello. And I said, oh, I've never seen you with a stick. And the person said, oh, I am still with a stick because you are not praying for me. So I took that as a big sign, and I prayed for him in the bus stop, and he wanted that. So that was so encouraging. In that moment, God created the circumstances, just perfect circumstances, in the most unusual place, with someone that simply we have seen just in local places passing by. And when I left and he took his bus, and I just continued walking, and then returning to the car, I just crossed the road and met an elder that we had seen earlier. Someone was helping her to cross the road precisely in front of our car, and the person was trembling, very fragile, vulnerable elder, and just also getting to a bus stop. And I just asked her, oh, hello, how are you? Do you want some prayers? And it was just a moment that I knew only God had engineered and created in that moment. So it was quite uplifting. So I hope that it is the beginning of something to live the great commission that Jesus gave us, to go to the world, to pray, to heal the sick, to cast out demons, and to live with the authority that he left us. That is what we want, and for that we want to leave everything. It's very difficult to find a group, to find a community where that to live Acts, to because Acts says everyone was living together, everyone would sell their possessions, sell their houses, come to live together and share everything in a community, developing each other's talents, sharing our talents, sharing our gifts, and helping each other to grow. That's the most important thing that we can find. Other people, the family of faith. We need to truly leave behind our friends, relatives, jobs, positions, titles, diplomas, to truly be able to live and activate the love gene, which is the genealogy as children of God. We are children of God if we believe. We are children of God if we accept and receive Jesus Christ. It's that simple. And we are so full of fear, doubts after so long, living by faith all these years, no money in the bank, no house, no possessions, no very little, lots of problems. It's not easy, but he gives us the strength. He gives us the power, the authority. In his mighty name there is power. Jesus Christ, Yeshua HaMashiach, King of Kings and Lord of Lords. And we want to live like he did. And we want to follow the kingdom. Follow the kingdom. Preach the kingdom. It's not an institution. It's not a religion. Jesus is not a religion. Just read the gospel. Read John. Read Acts. If you haven't got the time, just read. You read in a few hours. Spend one day. Give 24 hours to God one Sunday. Just stay in your house, just reading it. And you will find your own conclusions, you on your own. I just was feeling so emotional, so happy, so sad, so... confused, so... I know that God is closing so many doors, and I know that I just want to see that narrow gate, that narrow window that is so obvious that you need to go there. And I ask for your prayers that we find it, because it's quite challenging at the moment, and we are also experiencing amazing things. So it is just both intense light, intense love, and intense hate, because activating the love gene implies that people will hate you, and it's not the flesh and blood, it's the enemy will make it impossible for you to find the way, the truth, and the life. Will make it impossible, but in that you will find the strength, the motivation to continue, the motivation, the stamina. He will give you the love to overcome. Don't think that you have to love the Pharisees, the wicked. No. God will punish the wicked. In Psalms, you can read Psalms and see how David used to say, break the teeth of the enemy, bring the plagues to the enemy. God deliver us from the enemy. They deserve judgment. The commandments really imply to kill the enemy. All the words in the Old Testament are about getting rid of those who didn't follow the law of God. Promiscuity, homosexuality, Sodom and Gomorrah. Yeah, we are like Lot now, waiting to be rescued. With all these warnings about the rapture, that would be just amazing, just to get out of here after so many years of hard work and sharing his word and sharing his love has brought hate. But if he paid the ultimate price, which is death, and he in Revelations 12, he says, the dragon comes to attack those who keep the commandments and give their testimony of Jesus Christ. And earlier in that chapter, it says how to overcome. You overcome with the blood of the Lamb, the blood of Jesus Christ, who brought the new covenant. He paid with blood the price for all of us, for our sins. The punishment that we deserve, he took. We overcome with the blood of the Lamb, giving our testimony of Jesus Christ and not loving our lives unto death. So we leave you with these words, asking for your prayers. We need to leave Christianity. We need to follow Jesus. Not a religion, not a man. We need to ask the Holy Spirit. Jesus said in John 14 and 16, amazing chapters, I have so much to tell you, more to tell you, but you wouldn't understand. I will leave you the comforter, the counselor, the advocate, the Holy Spirit, the promise that they received in Pentecost. And he will remind you what I have said. He will teach you and he will lead you to all truth. So we need the Holy Spirit, and we are praying for that Holy Spirit right now. He's sending so many messages, so many wonderful things. But with the challenges that we have, you are bombarded, and when life is so tough, we are trying to listen that still, quiet voice that we know comes in dreams, visions, a book, a situation. And so we leave you with these words. Just wanted to share it with you, because it's tough. But in these moments, you find the most amazing miracles taking place as well. See you soon.